George and Amal Clooney have dinners with Meghan Markle and Prince Harry. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry don't eat dinner with just anybody. They dine with George and Amal Clooney. George Clooney said he and his wife, Amal, have dinners with the Duke and Duchess of Sussex. Clooney and his wife, Amal, have a home in Sonning, Berkshire, England near Markle and Prince Harry's newly renovated home, Frogmore Cottage, in Windsor. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex previously lived about 25 miles away in Nottingham Cottage on the grounds of Kensington Palace with Prince Harry's relatives as neighbors. According to a People magazine source, the move proved to be good for the couple. "Their home is so cute and warm," the source told People. "The energy of the space is so much better than Kensington Palace. It's a total fresh start," they added. As for George and Amal Clooney, they split their time between Lake Como, Italy, and England. They famously lent their private jet to the Duke and Duchess of Sussex when they stayed at their Italian villa. During an interview promoting his new Hulu original series, Catch 22, Clooney talked briefly about his and Amal's friendship with Markle and Prince Harry. "I've just known them," Clooney replied with a shrug when asked by the interviewer how he met the couple. In the next breath, he opened up a bit, just a teensy bit, more about his friendship with the couple. "We live not too far from one another and we have dinners and stuff and we're friends with them for all the reasons that you're friends with anybody," he added. The Ocean's 11 actor is known in Hollywood for being a prankster, but we don't know whether or not he's played a joke on his royal friends. "We'd love to know, but based on Clooney staying mum on details about his friends, he probably wouldn't share if he played a joke on them with the public." George Clooney calls Prince Harry and Meghan Markle nice, fun, kind people. Although Clooney didn't say whether or not he unleashed his sense of humor on Markle and Prince Harry, he did have glowing words to say about his friends. "They're just really nice, fun, kind people, they're a very loving couple, and they're going to be great parents," Clooney said. At the time of Clooney's interview, Markle had yet to give birth to Archie Harris in Mountbatten, Windsor. Funnily enough, Markle gave birth to baby Archie on May 6, 2019, which also happens to be Clooney's birthday. On the Ellen DeGeneres show, Clooney jokingly told Ellen DeGeneres the royal baby stole the spotlight from him on his birthday. When DeGeneres brought up Archie's birth, the 58-year-old actor said, "Yeah, I noticed that. That's stealing my game. Stealing my thunder." He threw in another joke, saying, "It's a good name. And it's better than Jughead, too." George Clooney compared Meghan Markle to Princess Diana. Clooney hasn't shied away from talking about Markle during interviews. In a particular February 2019 interview, he compared Markle to Princess Diana. "I do want to say, I just saw this piece. They're just chasing Meghan Markle everywhere," he said, according to Who. "She's been pursued and vilified. She's a woman who is 7 months pregnant and she is being pursued and vilified and chased in the same way that Princess Diana was, and it's history repeating itself. And we've seen how that ends." A month later, Clooney spoke out about Markle's treatment in the press again. "I think it's a little unfair," Clooney said on Good Morning Britain. "I've seen it when the press can turn on you for sort of ridiculous reasons and for almost nothing, and it seemed to be a little unjust since she hadn't done anything except just happened to live her life." It's clear Clooney stands up for his friends in interviews when he feels it's necessary. In the future, we hope he feels it's necessary that the foursome gets photographed in public together.